Undersecretary, I want you to set the record straight on this one. Were you offered the job of Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles? I mean, you have to tell us the truth on this. Were you offered that post?
I was informed that I am being considered for the position. Yes, I was informed.
You were offered, and who offered it to you? I'm curious. Who was the liaison that who informed you that you were offered the post? Like, would you want this post?
Karen, the presidency is imperial. It has a lot of people that can talk to you, but I'd rather not reveal that because I'm even surprised to be included in the list. There are more qualified, highly qualified for that position. I expressed no interest in that position. I did not.
So you turned it down.
I am thinking about it. I am thinking about it, and I am discussing it with my family.
All right. Well, now I can't leave you on this one, Assessor. I'm sorry. It's just too interesting. I mean, considering that you've put your passions, your time with railways. I mean, with the way the interview's gone, you know figures at the top of your head. Are you willing to leave railways to be press secretary? What's going through your mind? You said you're considering it. What are you going through? What are your considerations?
I said I did not apply. I said I did not express interest on that. But I'm part of a Marcos administration. I'm a good soldier. I really don't want to preempt what's
so
going
you
to be
said the, you're a good soldier. So if the president called you and said, Cesar, you need to take the job, you'd have no choice?
A soldier also speaks to a commander. You know, Karen, I am my education is military and defense. A good soldier is not a robot. It can discuss with a commander, but he does not discuss issues in public for public consumption until he is cleared to provide those information.
Okay. Now, on a more personal note, would you want to be press secretary? I mean, is that something you'd like to do?
I am. You know, railway is very challenging. This is going to be a good legacy of the Marcos administration. Yeah. The North-South Commuter Railway project going to carry around 500 to 600,000 passengers every day, connecting three regions, National Capital Region, Region 3, and Region 4. The Mega Subway is doing that also. We hope to complete MRT 7 by 2025. We hope to complete LRT Line 1 Extension Project by 2024, at least up to Paranaque 5 stations. We hope to complete the feasibility study, if not substantially completed, the Panay Railway Project. The President made mention about the Cebu Railway Project. The President made mention of the Mindanao Railway Project. There are many railway projects in the country that I think I can be more of service to the country if I focus on the railway sector.
All right. Well, on that note, Undersecretary Cesar Chavez, it's been a while, but I'm so happy to have you on Head Start.
Maraming salamat, Karen, and thank you for having me.
And I wish you success. And honestly speaking, if the railway project succeed, it will benefit the country. So I think you have the support on the country on that. So I do hope that it really goes full speed, as you've said on the show.
Maraming salamat.